on here, what you just heard was a lick in B minor. And I just wanted to let you know that you can get the tabs by clicking the link in the description. All right, so this one is in B minor and we're gonna start here on the B. And this is the lowest note of the six string arpeggio we're gonna start with. If you're not familiar with sweep picking or you need to, you know, brush up on that stuff, I have a ton of sweep picking lessons here on my channel. I will link to one of them at the end of the video. So let's start here, 7th fret, and we're gonna go up basically this bar chord shape. So we're only just gonna add this minor third here on the 10th fret as well. So we have 7, 10, 9, 9, 7, 7, 7. So, and the way that I'm picking this, down, hammer, down, 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 down. Just make sure that you do the rest strokes. You don't do this. You want to go, just fall to the next string. It should feel really effortless. So if you have a hard time getting the feeling right here, just do this. That's pretty much how it should feel, just adapted to whatever tempo you're practicing at. Okay, so. Then we're gonna add this note, and then that's gonna lead us to this note. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And from this note, we're gonna go up in this Yngwie sequence. So if we number the notes from left to right, 1, 2, 3, we're gonna play this. 3, 1, 2, 3, in each position of the B minor scale on the high E string. So basically, move up, move up, move up, move up, and then up to the root. So if you know your scale and you didn't know this sequence, for example, you would basically only need to learn one thing. You need to learn the sequence, because if you know the scale, you can just adapt that to the scale that you already know. So this is the reason why learning scales and knowing what you're actually doing is gonna speed up your learning a lot. And you're gonna avoid this whole bingo guitar playing that I talked about before, where basically you learn everything by going, oh yeah, it's gonna be on E, 10, 7, 9, 10, 12, 9, 10, 12. And you see only two positions here. You have 8 things to keep track of instead of knowing the scale and then learning the sequence and then, okay, I'm just gonna move it up the scale now. So don't fall into the trap of thinking that, I don't want to learn theory because it's gonna take time out of my, you know, learning musical phrases things or something like that, because you're gonna waste so much time not seeing how everything is connected. And at the end of the day, theory is not complicated at all. You have to remember it's musicians after all that came up with the system. It's not, you know, it's not rocket science. So and to learn any scale, any diatonic scale or 7-note scale, you need to be able to count to 7. And I think most of you are able to do that. So it's not difficult at all. And you will thank yourself if you actually spend the time doing that. Anyway, moving on here. So we get up here to a root note, again on the 19th fret. Now we're gonna go down in a B minor add 9 arpeggio. So we're gonna have 19, 14, so I'm gonna come to this note with a downstroke. Down, pull off, and then upstroke on the 15, pull off to 14, then we have 16, 16, 17, all swept, up, 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 and then downstroke on 16, and then finally end on 14 with an upstroke. So you have, so if we combine everything, and as in the previous video this week, I highly suggest you adopt the same type of practice technique using accents. And basically what the accents were, if you missed the previous video, well, go check that out. But just briefly here, this is based on 16th notes, so 4 notes per beat. And that means we're gonna have 4 different varieties here. We're gonna accent the first note. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up. And then you're gonna accent 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, 3 and 4. So you get 4 reps before you accented all notes in the entire lick. That's a really good way of practicing pretty much anything that's a bit longer like this. So give that a try, and again, start down here, go all the way up the fretboard. So I can't stress this enough, because it's not only that you get a different view of the shapes and all that stuff, because you change key when you move it around like that, but also you get different tensions. It's a very different tension here than it's up here, for example. And you need to get used to that, because otherwise, if you only practice things in one position, it's gonna be very hard to get the most out of that practice time. So always try to move things up and down the fretboard. And another reason why that's good is because you get that sort of I'm actually doing something effect, instead of just sitting there repeating something in the same place all the time. So you need that variety in your practice. And this is actually supported by science as well. They've studied this stuff where we need to have variety in our practice, because if we get that, you know, within some common sense boundaries, that will help you to learn much, much better. So your brain actually likes these different sort of challenges, and you know, the frets are bigger and then smaller up here, and all that kind of stuff will lead you to improve faster. Another thing that you should do when you practice pretty much anything is to work on transition time. And the transition time, I'm gonna link to that specific video that I made on this subject a few months ago. It's gonna be up here somewhere close to me, I don't know, maybe here. And check that out. And if you have any questions regarding this lick, just let me know in the comments below. And also, if you want the tabs, you can just check the link in the description. Other than that, have a great day and see you in the next video.